Radiant Team Ban. Complexities turn to ban. Ten seconds remaining. 5 seconds remaining. Reserve time. Radiant Team Pick.
Death Prophet.
Tiny.
Radiant Team Pick.
Alrighty, everybody, welcome back to the Shanghai Major American Qualifiers. It is Complexity Gaming here against Shazam in our last game of the evening, our last series of this evening, of course. The first day of American Majors qualifiers go pretty well, I have to say. It's a lot of fun hanging out with the Moonduck people and getting to see some good Dota. And this should be our best Dota of the day between two of the top tier teams so far here in the qualifiers. Complexity Gaming going against Shazam. My name is Mott. Joining me today is Purge. We have no stats, man. Purge, how the heck are you?
I'm great, and guess what? I put my push to talk to not enabled in Dota, so I should be in Dota TV. Thank
you. You're ready to go then.
My first game without tech issues. Aiming for it.
I believe in you. I hope you're right. We're gonna get this done. It's gonna be a great game. Already two heroes that. Well, actually, I've realized something over the past couple of hours is that I really just hate Death Prophet. I actually just hate her. I hate watching really? Her. I hate playing against her. She's not somebody that I enjoy.
She's
in Dota 2.
A little strong. I kind of liked the fact that they put all the heroes that got changed into the game. Thought that was cool, but it was maybe a little too fast. It was like a week or two or something. Like, almost nobody got a chance to play the heroes at all. But it definitely makes the game interesting to watch. It's a little chaotic and like that. As long as they do more hotfix patches, then I think it'll be fine.
Yeah, they'll change some things later on down the road, of course. I mean, like, they'll see the major qualifiers, they'll be like, okay, well, Death Prophet and Lone Druid are clearly strong. What do we need to do to change them to be adequate instead of first pick or first pay material? I guess Lone Druid's not quite first pick, first pay material, because there are other heroes you want to grab in other slots instead of just getting a one or a three position. But Death Prophet definitely seems pretty strong right now, and that's something I didn't see throughout the open qualifiers at all. It's just like right now during the main qualifiers, it's just like, huh, she's pretty good, huh? Spirit Siphon's pretty good, and they changed it so you don't have to get witchcraft to be effective at all.
Spirit Siphon is real strong. The only thing you're really lacking from is movement speed items don't accelerate as fast, and you need more mana regen. She barely needed any mana regen before, so now if you get Yules and Octarine, it's not a waste of mana regen. It's like a totally normal item build. So yep. That's the build on DP right now.
That's a good build too. Also, phase drum is obviously you're gonna get phase because the extra movement speed is really nice. So drum is sometimes picked up on the hero. We'll see if they need it. Do you have an enchantress so they could just pick up a drum on her? By the way, that's not banned out either, and I think enchantress is very strong with Dragonlance and just the ability of impetus in general right now. So, Complexity clearly are like, okay, well, we'll take care of Witch Doctor because we think it's really strong. Undying's Tombstone's really good, has been proven over this entire day of Dota. But they'll go ahead and grab up the Enchantress for themselves. And Complexity go for the Iotani, which has not had a ton of success today, at least not from what we've seen. So I'm kind of iffy about this.
Yeah. Wisp Tiny seems to be falling off a little bit. I don't know if teams are getting better playing against Tiny, or I think what it might actually be is teams are getting better at laning against the dual lane of Tiny IO. That's where Tiny gets a lot of his advantage from. And Tiny just doesn't scale that amazing against Enchantress. It reduces Tiny's attack speed, which he already has a lot of, so Tiny's a little bit more of an AoE hero, an AoE carry, than he is a single target. So Enchantress just kind of turns on her heel and walks away. Doesn't have to worry about Tiny too much.
This is... And they pick up a Bane, which I do think is good. I think Bane's actually pretty strong against the Enchantress. Something to lock her down so she can't just get away. We saw Mood play it very well, where he was like, nobody was able to hit her. Because she has Untouchable. She had a Yule Scepter. That's pretty strong.
Yeah, the when he turned on heal and then Yules himself, and then the heal, like he dropped from Yules and he had 400 HP. It heals you through your Yules. It's pretty
that
cool.
That seems very strong also.
Yeah, but it turns it from like a situation item to being like, okay, that's actually very, very good to have. That there's some really good synergy there.
Well, they will get a Tusk, so if the Bane is going to go ahead and Fiend Sweep, you can always Snowball. I'm out of it, I guess, is another thing you could do. I don't know. I think Tusk is a good choice, and you've mentioned this before. You're particularly, you like Tusk as an offer more than a bad, and you like Tusk, I think, probably a lot too, just because he has a high impact on the game.
Yeah, he does. He can gank mid very easily. You can go to runes, and Io has to be very careful. Like, Tiny would have to be nearby so he can tether. There's a lot of ways that Tusk is a lot better as an offlaner than Abaddon. Abaddon just kind of exerts pressure, and he is good, and he applies some nice things in the mid-game, but it's more like you're playing a farmed version of support Abaddon is the difference, and he just happens to have more levels earlier. I don't really always think that's the right way to play him.
Last pick coming out for this part of the picking phase, Complexity Gaming, you have 26 seconds left in reserve time. This draft has gone pretty quickly. I guess I missed a little bit of it, but they'll pick up Alina, which I'm down with. The first damage goes through Enchantress, that they take down the Death Prophet pretty quickly as well.
Yeah, and first this forces them into like BKB.
Yeah. That's what we've seen has been lacking, I think, a lot of these games.
And stuns aren't going to hurt either. Like, even if Lina doesn't have her ult, to just lock down Enchantress is going to make a big, big difference. Now, they've got good counters to it with Tusk, because Snowball is obviously going to disengage all that stuff, but I think the Lina is the way that players need to go to counter Enchantress. You can't base, like, typically, like you do normally. You have to draft.
5 seconds remaining.
Shazam now, maybe they have to... I don't know what you go for now. Like, how do you deal with Lina? How do you deal with the burst damage? A Dazzle might be good just to be able to grave. I'm surprised that hasn't been picked up yet, actually.
Against Complexity? So you're saying Shazam pick it?
Yeah.
I'm not sure. Maybe just a little bit of run at you heroes. That way you need somebody to like take aggression while Enchantress sits back and pings away. But I guess DP kind of... Maybe Dazzle's an okay pick. Damage is going to scale very well just by them being about even on farms. So a Dazzle might be a good way to solve that problem. I like Venge as well. They can swap Io Tiny to break the tether so that Tiny is a little bit more solo. They can break Bane's Fiend's Grip a bit better. It's a good way to cover the burst that Complexity's doing is by putting an ally less out of position. So Venge Tusk, even if Tusk is a support, is a really good way to do this.
I do like Shazam's draft in the sense that you don't know where everyone's playing at. I mean, we've seen Enchantress in a variety of roles. We've seen Tusk in a variety of roles. We've seen Venge in a variety of roles. I think the only constant right now is the Death Prophet is almost 100% mid, and Venge is more than likely a support. I'd be very surprised to see otherwise. And I kind of agree with you with having a tanky frontliner. You could put that in your one position for Shazam. Maybe something like a Bristleback, although I'm not sure how I feel about it this game.
Yeah, if anything, I think something like Bristle would work better on Complexity, because I think it's decent versus Enchant. It ended up not working out that one game, but I feel like, I can't remember who was playing that game. We casted it, there was a Bristle versus Enchant, was there?
I think so. I
seem to remember it didn't do anything, though. I think that was because of the silence, mostly. They'd, like, silence him, and he wouldn't be able to quill that often.
Maybe yeah,
just punish the Enchant in the early lanings. Well, he doesn't lane any jungles, so you can't really do that either. I don't know. It's a hard problem, how to beat Enchantress.
I definitely prefer Shazam's draft right now, if I had to say something. If I had to pick a side, I think it would be Shazam currently. That could change with the draft as we get the last picks coming out. I'm not sure.
5 seconds remaining.
Well, Complexity's last pick is going to be a offlane hero. Reserve time. So something that can help deal with Death Prophet, be some kind of a damage amper, whether that's a Slardar or something else. I don't think they'll do Slardar, though. I don't really like Slardar that much.
I think it should be something more along the lines of like Magical Burst, but I mean, that works. Somebody that could get in your face and just roar you down, and then...
I have a counter with both Venge and Tusk, though. I've already got the solutions to those. But as long as they go with somebody that isn't either, it's just so hard, man. Snowball is so good.
Yeah.
It's like Disruption plus so many other things.
That's why we, like, never see Shadow Demon, I think. Like, he's, like, He does have the damage amplification, which I think is fine. But Tusk does it so much better with his AoE disruption. We've been calling it that forever, but that's exactly what it is. And you get a blink dagger, it's even better than that. I don't know. I think Shazam, again, still have a good draft. I like the idea of a Beastmaster, because he will have Vision. You're on the Dire side. They don't have that great of a Roche lineup. I guess Beastmaster with Inner Aura or Inner Beast is okay. You could maybe take Roche quickly.
That's actually a nice counter to Enchantress. So you buff up at your whole team's attack speed. That way, the Untouchable does a lot less.
That's fair. Plus, they have Fiery Soul with Lina. And if he doesn't burst her down magically.
Good point. Yeah. If Lina's their mid, and or if Lina farms safe and just like levels up a lot, maybe goes 4-1-4, she can actually kill Enchantress, because let me check the math. It's like 85 attack speed per spell you cast if you have level 4. So with one skill point, or if she casts one spell, alright, if she has, what's the counter? Like 2 or 3 levels of Fiery Soul and she casts 2 spells, she's going to be attacking it normal, basically.
Maybe you're missing out on levels of stun, though.
Well, it's not that big of a deal. You're only really losing stun duration.
Yeah, the damage scales from
80 to 200.
Yeah, you're right about that. Yeah, that's fair. Solaris the last pick for Sam. That kind of fits, and it's not really a tanky frontliner, but he is very elusive and hard to deal with. Roar is pretty good. There's a lot of good Dark Pact abilities here. I mean, he's pretty, like I said, he's elusive, so he can just jump away from a lot of these heroes, with the exception of the Bane. I don't know, it's kind of weird that they pick Slark in this game, but...
It's a little weird, but it's going to be pretty good at picking off both Lina and the Io, and Bane as well. He can be a pretty big menace to those heroes, so... And Beastmaster's not going to be able to lock him down very well. And it also, this is kind of a weird advantage, but in most cases, or in some cases, they'll be able to see if the Hawk and or Observer...
That's a good point.
That might be...
It's like an added little bonus.
Yeah.
Nice, I like the casual question mark already at the beginning of this game. SVG's going to be real manner about it, say quick emergency. You don't need to answer that, MXVG.
I think that means he has to go to the bathroom.
Yeah, I think you're right, yeah. Quick emergency can mean anything. That's the problem. I wonder if these teams like hate each other. Feels like they would, kind of.
Why?
I don't know, man. Just any Dota, dude. That's just, I get the feeling.
This is literally 3 Swedes. And... Yeah. 2 brothers versus NA Dota.
Right. I don't see the problem here.
Yeah, me neither. This seems totally fine.
Okay, it's not like Swedes can't, like, hate people, you know? They're nice people, but... You know, we're not even going to talk about this, because I'm trying to stir up the pot and get drama going. You're not having any of it, clearly.
Drama has been had.
All right. It's now about Dota. We don't need to hear about this drama crap.
MSS is playing Tusk support again.
Played it pretty well. MSS has been very surprisingly good this tournament. In the one series we saw with him, his Shen was own edge. His Tusk was very strong. Well, it was good. I don't want to say it was very strong. It was a good Tusk. Nothing like outlandishly amazing. But... So I think the winner of this series is probably the one that's going to make it to Shanghai. That's how I feel about this anyways. I think that's it's a little too early to say that. But
are you saying, but where's their standings in terms of points and stuff?
Well, this is the second game in this group besides the Power of Friendship Not Today one, which has just started as well. And Power of Friendship is they 2-0 Not Today, I believe. So it's actually Power of Friendship and Shazam are sitting at 2 points. Team Freedom, as well as Not Today, are sitting at 0 points, and Complexity is yet to play yet. So, this is Complexity's first game. If they 2-0 Shazam, I feel very confident about their chances to make it out of this group and into the playoffs. If it's a 1-1, I still feel very good about Complexity's chances. If Shazam 2-0s, then I feel like they will more than likely make it to Shanghai because of beating Complexity, which I think is a very strong team. If you understand what I'm saying, right? It's these are the 2 teams in this group, is what I'm trying to get at here.
I see. So you're saying if they do well against Shazam, then they're probably going to beat the other teams and therefore get out of their group.
Exactly.
Yeah, but once you get to the qualifier matches or whatever you want to call them, like that's, you're still talking about like best of 3s, and that's just dangerous, man.
That's true. It's what? It's the 4 teams in the playoffs, I believe. Yeah, I'm pretty sure top 2 teams move on in each group. Unless there's like a 3rd team that goes to the loser's bracket, which I'm sure there's not.
Plus they have to play the other good teams. Like, even if they are the best in their group, it doesn't mean they're going to Shanghai, you know?
Right. Okay, well. Wait, what the hell? Huh. That's strange. Never mind. So I'm just trying to look at Wikipedia and try to get back to the page. It had all the main qualifiers in one area. And I'm like looking for it and I can't seem to find it. So that's not good. This is a real big emergency, man. Jesus.
What if, like, he has to drive somewhere for 5 minutes because his mom forgot her key?
That's a weird, oddly specific emergency.
I'm just saying that it's probably something where you're not going to be like, hey, guys, I have to drive somewhere for 5 minutes because my mom forgot her keys at the bowling alley, and it's really important because she has to work in the morning. It's so much easier to say, like, emergency.
That's true. I mean, it could be one of those things. It could be something. Dude, I just want to watch Dota. I've been up for a while. I got stitches removed today. I'm actually super tired. And I want to see good Dota. And that's just not happening right now. And I'm being spoiled.
We saw some good Dota.
No, I mean, we have seen good Dota. I want to see more good Dota. I want to get this game underway. If we have to wait 5 more minutes, I'm going to lose it, dude. God, I'm the worst.
This is going to be like our 7th actual cast of the night?
Yes. Because we did 3 series, but 6 games. So this will be our 7th, that's right.
Hey, I think I'm going to be done after this set, but I don't know if I'm screwing people over by doing that or not.
I am done as well. Most certainly.
Is that us screwing people over?
I don't think so, because we're only slated. I put on the schedule that I was only going to do these games.
Well, I didn't put my name on the schedule at all, actually. I just completely ignored the schedule, and I just show up. I'm like, hey,
I'm here, ready to cast. Let's go, everybody. No, I mean, you're not screwing everybody over. Slax has got his birthday, so he's doing his own thing. Sons of Ben will be back after Americas. And they'll get subs to do on the Moonduck stream. And since there's no Americas, it's not like we're slated to do anything else. The only thing we need right now is a Chinese cast for the first 2 games. But we're already missing the first game. The second game, I'm not sure if anyone's going to be around for it. And then after that, we're fine. Like, how are we possibly screwing anybody over?
I don't know, I'm just worried.
Don't worry about it. You're thinking too hard about this.
Okay.
We're literally fine. We don't even have to cast this. Like, I mean,
I basically didn't show up to work for 4 days while I played the open qualifiers, and then here I am. So I basically was completely uninvolved in the play.
Well, you were playing, to be fair.
I was playing.
And we're like, okay, we're not going to bother Kevin. He's doing his own thing right now. He's doing very well for himself. He's playing, he's getting the top 4. You know, that's great. So it has nothing really to do with you. We're not screwing anybody over. And I'm glad we were able to cast this. I never thought we were going to be able to get in the lobby, you know, first of all. So the fact that we're actually in here casting is pretty nifty.
Ooh, Rex might die.
They did not get the nightmare off in time.
Thanks.
Good tether. Oh, dirty ice shards from MSS. Get that hawk. Yeah, get that 30 gold reef.
Good. 25 experience, dude. That's probably a bounty rune.
Yeah, really. That gets you started off right. Speaking of bounty runes, top rune spell will be taken by complexity. This looks like the dual lane mid of an IO and Tiny. Swindles will head bottom as the offlaner, it looks like. And then Chessie's getting me the safe lane on Alina, so... She's also rotating mid. I don't know. Whoever picks up this bounty rune is going to be getting...
Looks like it'll be Tiny here.
So yeah, I guess they just stopped giving the rune to Aya, right? Because he already has almost a bottle, right? Pretty much at the start of the game.
Well, he got a south shield, so not exactly. But... Are you talking about Wisp?
Oh, the Aya.
Wisp will get one really fast. That's pretty standard.
It's like 20 gold from now, so 20 seconds, less than 20 seconds even, he'll have a bottle. He doesn't need the rune anymore, which I thought was pretty cool. That was the nice little side change. All right, so Ritsu just needs to come out like even or. Yeah, if he comes out even in this lane, he's pretty much won it. He's getting the extra experience. Well, more experience than what?
Double ward in the same area? That's a bit weird.
Oh, this sentry? No. What the heck? Super ward here and here? I guess they're kind of concerned about the IO Tiny taking this camp, maybe?
This is the laziest block on this camp I've ever seen, actually. Problem is that they couldn't get through, I guess, but... You could say that was good on Tusk because he created that little shield. But this camp, you can like block it. It's like huge. It's like actually so big.
And so you can put him
right
anywhere.
On the site.
Where would you put it? X marked where you would put it.
I'm not sure. I don't know the exact thing. Oh, Brax might die here.
I guess. Hello.
Oh, maybe Zeepik now.
Yeah, he's actually gonna barely live, looks like. I almost got the kill. The offlane Enchantress mixed with the Tusk. The salve will come out from Zeepik. I'm telling you, man, I like the draft better on the Radiant side. Ritsu gets tossed back. No tether slow coming out yet. Now it will, finally. He's still in a lot of trouble here. Good body blocks. Pops the Fairy Fire. There's the Spirit Siphon, however. And so the toss will come through. It's not going to be enough damage. How far are they willing to die for this? He's got Crypt Storm. Might be able to get Hanskin. Oh, just barely out of range. The last tower hit will not go. He'll barely survive.
I don't know, I feel like he should have really turned earlier. The moment that I felt like he was safe was when he was juking to this point, and that was when you turned. But he didn't nuke until he was down here. He got way too scared there.
Yeah, I mean, I would be... Well, not really, because they didn't have Toss or Avalanche. He didn't have the mana for it, so there's not really any reason for him to be scared. But either way, he still survives. They waste a little bit of time. He's still setting it 4 losses to the 9 of the Tiny. So getting out to a good start is complexity. Limp's already doing pretty well for himself. He's got the Stout Shield and Boots. So good things happening right now for Complexity. They have 7 last hits for the Chessie Lina, and then Mason down bottom has a couple last hits as well, sitting at 7. What does the Enchantress have, 4? Not that great. I mean, this dual lane, I feel like this dual lane offlane should be getting a lot more done. Maybe that's too much to ask, but...
You're referring to the Enchantress and the Tusk, right?
Yes.
Well, they did get that camp blocked, and in fact, the sentry that MSS placed also blocks it.
Well,
that's how big it is.
Yeah, that's pretty huge.
I think you can block here as well if you're right on. Just have to go a little bit more north for the sentry for that to work, right?
Yeah. I actually have no idea what the spawn boxes is. I saw you guys were actually in a map called Neutral Spawn Boxes, so.
It's that, really that good if you change, play right? If you play support or offlane, you should really check out that.
Yeah. I'm going to have to at some point. Uh-oh. Urgency. Not a great time to DC. No, that's just DC right there, straight up. That's not good.
Little poor man's shield up against the boars. Really good choice. Oh, this boar does 30 damage. That's crazy. It's not bad at all, actually. Piercing, I guess, but...
And especially to a
to heroes.
Squishy Slark, but he does have a PMS, and he's got a lot of regen too. He's level 3 now in the Slark. What's happening? How does he just DC like that? I don't want to say the word, but hopefully it's not that.
Complexity is definitely having a bit of trouble playing though. Ritsu's only got 8 last hits compared to the 10. And Wisp even has one as well, so a combined 6 denies in the mid lane versus the 8 total last hits that Ritsu's got. So I feel like finally we've got a Wisp Tiny that's actually being played really well.
Yeah, they're doing stuff finally. They have one now on Tiny as well because the Crypt Storm spam. The bottle is up on Hanskin. I think it was ferried out and it's going to be coming back in. And Limp will get a Belt of Strength. Hanskin's going to pick up a Gauntlet of Strength for for Urn. I was kind of confused. I was like, wait, who's Hanskin playing? But he's playing the Isle. So he'll be getting the Urn, which is not unusual. This is pause central. There's nothing worse in Dota than pause.
Man, we're so spoiled lately. Like, there's almost never pauses, but...
God.
In Dota 1, it was actually the worst. Somebody would DC and you'd be like, well, we're screwed.
Yeah, that's actually a pretty good point. It's not even that. It's just like, there was a game, 2 years ago, I was casting with Gerg, and it was a 2-hour pause, and I'm not sure how we survived that. I don't even think we didn't even like go to an AFK screen. We just sat there for 2 hours talking shit. You know how hard that is to do with Gerg?
Hang out with Gerg for 2 hours?
Just talk shit with Gerg for 2 hours.
Talk shit or hang out with him?
Well, I mean both. I mean like I use the word talk shit as like hang out. All right, you know, my newfound lingo is not working out. I'm just gonna use
I love watching all the new wards. There's been so many good ward placements. This one at the top rune is really cool. It's like almost as good as the one to the left of it. Harder to deward, less likely.
Wait, the one that's above the creep camp?
Yeah. It scouts north. Like if you look at the map, it scouts up here. And it gives you some vision down.
It's a very narrow area that it does scout.
But narrow vision is really all you need, you know?
Yeah, see somebody at that camp, somebody walking up to the high ground. It's an all access point that you're going to see somebody walk through at the end of the day. I am confused because you talked about this earlier. Why do you get two wards in that same area? I think they both get the top rune spot. Maybe the top one doesn't. I'm not sure.
I think they wanted a spot to see if there was going to be Bane rotations. If there's a Bane rotation mid, then the Death Prophet would die. I guess if they smoke, then they... I'm not sure. It seems like a bit of a bad ward to me. They'll ask MSS about it later.
But. Yeah. Riksu's going to be sitting mid, and he's still trying to get some CS here. I mean, he could have got... If he got that kill on Hanskin, how much of a difference would that have made? Maybe not that much. TP bottom, they're looking to get a kill. That's the first blood coming out. Oh, God. I was talking at my camera work.
I wasn't looking either. So. Yeah, it would have been huge if he killed the Wisp. It would have been really, really big, but he didn't. Like, his bottle, he just got his bottle, but he could have, like, bottle boots if he got that kill.
He'll get a 4-minute bounty rune. No boots still, like you talked about. Doesn't have that because he didn't get that first blood. He'll pop up the bounty rune. Double damage revenge, by the way. We can try to get a gank here. Avalanche gonna fly through, toss back as well onto Hanskin. Shazam in some trouble. Ritsu pops up the Spirit Siphon. Cryptstorm will go. And there's the Wave of Terror. They're gonna back away. Ice Shard, Snowball in, might get two here. Hanskin will be the first of all. Spirit Siphon gets the kill, but he does die. The Giant Siege creep lands on him. He could have survived that, but still, I think he got both of those kills. Yes, he did get the experience and gold for both of those kills, staying alive just in time. I think he bought.
He's okay with that. I think that was a really good turn of events for Shazam. They got levels on both of their supports. They have two supports that are at level 4, for God's sake. Like, that is ridiculous. And the Death Prophet got the kill, the gold for both. Like, that was just a huge boost to the supports of Shazam here, and that's going to help them a lot in the mid game.
I think he lost a lot of that gold when he died, because he only had 150 before he was in that fray, and then afterwards, it's not like he has boots or anything, he didn't buy out, so I was wrong about that. Avalanche is going to go toss, they miss it, it's actually going to do a creep, Magic Missile's going to go, but they overcharge, flies up as well, Crypt Swarm, of course, that overcharge helping him reduce that a lot of that damage, and so Limp will back away. I like how they're fishing for these, though, they're doing a really good job of it.
Yeah, I mean, you can do it every time Tiny's Avalanche is off cooldown, 17 seconds, you know. I think they saw the ward go down.
Yeah, I think that was pings. MSS pinging. I'm not sure. It could have been the lead. No, it was
yeah. He was watching the Wisp. He saw his items. They have the Observer Ward up to spot the ward getting put down. So
they have a Sentry. Avalanche, here you go. Another toss-up. Not back, though. Ritsu doesn't have Spirit Siphon. It's on cooldown for another second here. The Spirits will go, and they'll right-click the Hammer Fist. Coming up from Limp will do the job. SVG will Wave of Tear up. He'll try to get to level 6 here. That's very early level 6 coming up for the Ventral Spirit with this wave coming through. Sure, he died, but... Early support levels, like you mentioned, are so huge.
It maybe could have gotten a kill there, but I don't know. MSS covers the rune here, which is good, but he could have stacked and done that. He's just being slightly inefficient this time.
What does Mason have? Treads down bottom, most lessons in the game by about one. Beastmaster's got 26 lessons, though. That's pretty insane, but the Enchantress also has 24. It's really just Ritsu that's not having a great time. Oh my god, my camera work.
Okay, I caught it. I'll tell you exactly what happened.
All right,
basically, Tusk ran to the top lane. Brax found him into the jungle. He was trying to zone the Enchantress, and they just nuked him a couple times. He tried to TP after he nightmared Tusk, and then they woke Tusk up with the creep, and then he just snowballed to interrupt the TP. Really straightforward kill. As soon as he got found by those two heroes, he's dead.
All right, I got you. I think.
It was easy. That's what I'm trying to say.
Okay, I got you. I understand. Arcane's for MSS now with level 4. Level almost 6 for Enchantress. He's gonna hit that level 6. He's gonna start roaming around. Hitting like a freight train, as Enchantress is want to do. Limp is gonna have the Bracer now with the treads. So he's looking to go drum, or just casual Bracer, probably drum. So no early Blink Taker for him. Mason, he can also go for drum. I'm not sure what item he's gonna pick up. We'll pick up the wand first and then have the TP scroll. Ritsu's getting bottle crow mid lane. They haven't been fishing for avalanche tosses out as much, and Limp will go ahead and clear a creep wave by doing so. Back top, Mistress is up here, maybe looking for the Lina. Chessy is going to be here on the side. Z-Freaks will going to be behind him. Chessy's going to walk up. There's the Ice Shards. They'll catch him. They've got the Nightmare. They'll use it right on top of Brax, but still. They won't go for the kill, actually. Now he'll try to TP away, and he actually just makes it out. There's no snowball up ready to go for MSS, so he wouldn't be able to stop him, even if he wasn't Nightmared. Brax didn't have vision for the damage with the impetus.
So strong when he hits 6, though. Like, even though he doesn't get a kill right now, like, that's gonna scale really well and going into the mid game.
Do you think he's gonna rotate out of this lane? Like, is he actually gonna, like, Chrome?
No, he's definitely going to stay here, I think. The only thing he really fears is relocate, I think. Once Wisp gets his ultimate, then things get a little scary for Brax, but for now, he can just sit in his lane for a long time.
Speaking of the Wisp and relocate, he's going back home. He's very low. I'm pretty sure Quipstorm just owned him. No Exorcism, he'll TP back mid, bottle up as well. He actually wasted a bottle charge there. Toss casually onto Ritsu. Down
broke
bottom.
His clarity. Like he needs to fill up his mana. It's one of the bad things about Death Prophet. If you're behind, you can't just AFK jungle as well as you could before.
Oh, there's an Arcane Room bottom that they're just kind of leaving there. They have vision of it. Is Hans going to go for it? He's thinking about it. Might stack Ancients.
I mean, he wanted to grab it, but it's going to be gone now.
No,
it's not. That's actually a really good rune to get. His mana was full as well. He could get so many Crypt Swarms out of this item or rune.
He might pop in and just bottle up. Good Hawk placement. They see the rotation from SVG back down towards the bottom lane. Almost level 6. So he's going to have swap. They might want to get something done with it pretty soon. Fred's done for Chessie. Chessie has a little bit less net worth than that of the Enchantress. So already a good job done in this dual lane aggressive lane coming out. I really enjoyed Enchantress MSS Tusk dual lane aggressive lane. It's done a pretty good job.
Yeah, it's been pretty good, but Chessie does. I guess his last hits are a little bit low. He's only got 41.
You've got to be kidding me. I literally take it off 1 second. Limp will grab the kill onto Ritsu. It takes half a second for them to do that combo, and I take my camera away for that moment, and they get the kill onto Ritsu. Never going to hear the end of this.
They've done a great job. This is going to completely change the whole game. Like, if they don't do a good job killing Death Prophet in the laning stage, they have a terrible game ahead of them. The Death Prophet that you keep seeing. Like, that's one of the ways to counter DP. You just crush her in lane because her HP is not very high.
Yeah, and this is not going to give her any, you know, phase, Yules, drum.
Yeah.
She's very far behind. I mean, the supports are almost as farmed as her. She's really struggling.
It's just so important that you kill her with a dual lane. Because if you do that, it doesn't cost you smokes. It doesn't cost you heroes across the other side of the map. They're killing her with two heroes. They're making Tiny Wisp. What Tiny Wisp do? Gank bottom.
Swindle's gonna get caught out. There's the Pounce Dark Pact as well, and I thought they might relocate to save them, but they were TPing mid as that happened. Couldn't have relocated, and I don't know if that would have been the best idea towards that tower. He would have been dead by the time they got there. So good kill. They smoked up for that, by the way, and so that'll be a dead Beastmaster for 20 seconds, while Brax will stay top now alone without the help of the Tusk. That is a Blink Dagger. He just went for the casual Bracer, so now Limp could do this pretty much all on his own. He doesn't really need Hanskin. He'll use him for relocate ganks, and they'll be together stacking up and going to work. Otherwise, though, he could roam around the map, blink, and get involved in fights on his own with maybe the help of some other supports or other heroes like Chessie, as well as the Bane play by Z-Freak.
As long as he carries the TP, I'm sure Tiny's going to be able to
do that. Oh, they're relocating. Brax is in trouble. Avalanche, I think, might have missed. They do get the toss, so the combo does go, and the B-Sap will finish everything off. I thought he might have just been off the mark a little bit with that Avalanche, but that's not the case. Complexity will have four heroes top lane, and this tower should go. They're gonna keep the Tiny here. They're even gonna toss, but it was flipped up nicely. Good ice shards, pushing them back a little bit. But this is gonna be, I believe, maybe not the back away actually.
They have so many nukes on their team. That was pretty amazing. Like, even Brainstaff on top of that. Like, there's a nice juke there by Brax, but it's just every single nuke came out and he died.
Yeah.
They gotta do to beat
Toss, Avalanche combo, Ritsu in trouble mid lane. Spirit Cypher will not save him, but here comes Brax. The Impetus, Ice Shards missed on the left. Here comes the Snowball. Can they bring him down? There's the Overcharge. Walrus Punch gets up, but now they have the Fiend's Grip going through the Z-Freak, and MSS will fall. And Brax is just not doing enough damage. His mana's out of whack at this point. He's got 9-6 charges still ready to go, but still nightmared up. They won't go any further. As Limp, he does have the combo, but he's very scared of who else is gonna roam up. As nearby, there was Mason, who TP'd in. And he will have a Shadowblade as well. Down bottom, roar up on SVG. Can he get this kill? He's got Necro 1 and SVG. Magic Missile's not there. He got actually destroyed from that mana drain. Mason will go ahead and try to clear these out. Taking a lot of damage, though. He needs to be very careful. Top lane. Brax in trouble. Toss have a combo, and they're just doing work now. All across the map, they get the top tier 1 tower. Limp comes in with the Blink Dagger combo. He might even get a tier 2 in this top lane as well.
And the biggest difference between like Shazam and Complexity right now is Complexity is just getting way more value out of their lanes. They're doing more with less. They're getting more kills with fewer heroes, so they're getting more farm and they're getting more ganks off over time. Like the mid lane alone has been like absolutely devastating.
What does Ritsu have now? He's got phase. It's nothing else, I don't think. He's gonna Bottle Crow real quick. Yeah. So he is sitting at 3,000 net worth. He's less than the Enchantress in the offlane. So that's something to be concerned about. Swindles almost has his level 2 Necromove book, by the way, so that's pretty nifty. And he got a solo kill there on SVG with level 1 Necromove book.
Yeah, that solo kill is really big.
This game is going to get very hard, I think, for Shazam.
And his Necro 3 is going to cover him quite well against Sarkhan teamfights, so... Looks like they're going to be doing a smoke. There's a lot of grouping coming out of Shazam here. Yeah, maybe they're just anticipating the push on Ritsu.
They have one on SVG, they're going to use it on 4. They have a Shadow Blade for Mason. And he's going to follow the team. He'll regen up here in a moment.
It's a little low, man. This is kind of dangerous for him, honestly.
They have Arcanes. They have Arcanes on MSS. So they can maybe fight this. They're thinking about it. This could be a huge team fight for them. They can turn things around. Blimp could be a big target, but they can have Relocate out. Something to keep in mind. They have actually no idea where they want to go. They thought about going mid. They backed up mid. And they're actually all missing. The Hawk will scout out Mason, but nobody else. The smoke's still keeping them covered.
I think they were just checking for Ancient Stacks and getting wards down, which they did. So they accomplished that at least. And they know now that if Tiny gets Eggs, it's not that big of a deal because they don't have to contest the Ancient spot. They have a lot to kill, though.
Is Limp gonna just go with the Axes, the Ogre Club, so it could go BKB. I'm not sure that's really the best item, though. I'm not sure it's necessary.
BKB's, that doesn't stop enchant damage, it does stop a lot of what other Shazam does.
I mean, if you get Exorcism, there's right click coming out from the Slark. I don't think he's gonna go BKB. I think this is just the start of an Aghanim Scepter, but I've been wrong before. They're gonna try to clear out one of the last tier 1 towers in the game. The Toss will not do the damage on time. Chessie coming in, he's smoked up, by the way, looking for a target. No Yules, though. SVG's walking up. Will they back together? Complexity say, I don't think so. This is a bit sketchy. We're going to back away. So, they'll let it go.
SVG shouldn't have shown there on the creep wave. It's a bit of a mistake. Now they know that they're all there. But I guess they have the Hawk anyway, so maybe it doesn't matter.
Where is that Hawk right now?
To the north.
This is a Radiant Hawk? Oh, they enchanted it. That's nice.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about that. That's actually so good.
Here's the other Hawk down here towards the bottom area. Bottom rune spot. Oh, they denied the tier 1 tower mid nonetheless. Mason is the only one really with farm on the Radiant squad. The Enchantress is starting to fall behind because she's not really farming in the jungle. The Death Prophet's taking the majority of the jungle stacks now. She's got a bracer for what is probably a drum because they need one still. They don't need one, but it's just a nice thing to have. They also have another bracer, I think that's on, it's on Mason and Ritsu. Top lane.
He's gonna be looking for the Wisp in the back.
Yeah, he sees him now. He's gonna walk right into him. He's gonna jump up, and Hanskin can maybe try to relocate away. He's not gonna make it out, actually, if he tried for it. Too much right-click damage from Mason, and he gets a kill on a couple of Essence Shift stacks.
Yeah, if Tiny had Avalanche there, he would have tried to save him, but his Avalanche is on cooldown, so at best he could have, lost the Slark in the air and low chance of saving the Wisp.
Necro 2 done down bottom. Tier 1 tower is going to get glyphed. No trade happening as there's not a creep wave up there. And this tower is not even really that low. There's now a Yules for Chessie, so they have the setup on top of that to find a couple of easy kills. They have really good burst damage for Complexity. Like, that was what we talked about in killing the Enchantress, is not what they had. Leviathan didn't have that against Moo in the last game that we just watched. He's going to try to go for, I think, the Dragonlance. He has the Ogre Club, so Brax is going to be getting that. But look at this. Tier 1 tower for a Roche.
Not the best trade for Shazam, but they're a little bit on the back end here, or on the backside, so they kind of have to take what they can get.
They have to maybe push to the Tier 2 tower top lane? Maybe they can go for it.
Beastmaster just provides so much value right now. The attack speed auras, these are the heroes that counter Enchantress really nicely. Beastmaster and, it's like having a Vengeful Spirit on your team, kind of. Except the attack speed aura is, in this case, much stronger.
And now look at those creep wave where it's situated, too. That's really great. They come out of Roche, they find a creep wave down at the bottom tier 2 tower, and they say, we can push this now. There's not really much Shazam can do to contest this. Maybe they could pop up their Exorcism. They have Mason Shadowblade again, and Complexity are actually playing this a little cautiously, but maybe for the best. This should be a tower, I think. I don't know if you can test this if you're Shazam.
They did not see Slark when he retreated, so... I mean, they're just... it's dead.
God, the Necro... is that Necro 3 now? It is.
Z see if they can find any wards with it as well.
There's nothing nearby.
The melee one's dead already, it looks like.
Yes. Okay, well, what's the net worth advantage right now? Almost 7,500 for complexity.
That is huge at 18 minutes. That is really big. That mostly comes down to them owning the mid lane and then transitioning that into some Enchantress kills. Chant has not been able to get off ground as well as she would like to.
She just got that Ogre Lance, but Tiny just picked up an Aghanim Scepter. Oh, right. What did I call it?
Ogre Lance.
I keep doing that. I have no idea why.
An ogre should use a lance, though. Like, a really big spear. Why would they only use clubs? I know they're stupid.
I mean,
because
yeah, exactly. That's why. Because they're dumb and stupid. That's why I think that's the misnomer about ogres. Okay, so they will stack this up, though. You talked about checking for ancient stacks, and there are a couple now. And this ward will see them, though, for the raiding team. They have this ward.
They delayed it a little bit. Like, I guess the raiding team can't kill it, but if you stack it up and you don't have eggs yet, it's a little dangerous. There's always the chance the enemy team will take it.
I actually like the raiding's vision. They have really good ward placements. Not to say that Complexity doesn't. They have good ward placements. Plus, they have the hawk.
You saw the Slark, I think.
Mason?
Aiming for some free kills.
Z-Freak? Oh, he puts a sentry down. He saw him. He picked him out. I think Mason saw the attack animation go, and he's going to back up. Limp knows that he's there, though. He could go for a blink. They now see that he's in lane, but this is kind of a bait, as there's a couple of heroes behind him. They saw the Crypt Storm from Ritsu. Limp's still chasing and is instead going to go to work on this creep wave. Meanwhile, down bottom, Swindle's just split pushing like crazy. And they have to be back home.
Or blink money.
That's pretty ridiculous. 2,400 gold. Yeah, there it is. He'll buy it and have it ferried out to him. Jesse will get an Invis rune as he's heading towards Shadowblade, so he doesn't really even need it right now. I mean, he will, though, later on down the road.
It's looking very good for Complexity.
Yeah, I mean, they're just going to take this tier 2. They can push high ground with the Aegis they have. They have all the items they really need. Enchantress is not doing anything. Mason's really... he's just a Shadowblade at this point, and he's pretty squishy. Now that we're going to relocate mid, Yules comes out, Richie's caught. There's the Dragon Slayer Laguna. They blow him off, and the Fiend's Grip was beautifully done from Z-Freak. Great combo, and they find Mason down bottom. A solo kill comes out for Swindle Melons, and that might just be the beginning of the end. These last tier 2 towers are going to fall in the push high ground here and try to force out buybacks.
Dude, a solo kill from the offlane into the carry at this stage in the game is so powerful, but that's what Beastmaster does, man. He can kill almost any hero with Necro 3. And if he catches Slark with Aurora, just waits for the Dark Pact to come out immediately after, goes through the Blink Stun. And if he doesn't react in time with his ult, he dies. Really easy kill. And Complexity is playing really good here.
No, they really
remind me a lot of Complexity at the TI qualifiers. They just played way better than everybody else.
Yeah. They're doing that now. Their 5-man is very strong. They've got such a great advantage from Limp as well as Hanskin in that mid lane. Ritsu got absolutely decimated for the first time today that we've seen. We've only watched it 3 times, to be fair. But
And to be fair, some of those Death Prophet games were DC playing, and Yuar, I think, is a better player than Ritsu, so that may be clouding our judgment a little bit.
That's true. I still don't like the hero. I still think that hero is not fun to watch. But when she's getting trashed, and this is not a reflection on Ritsu, I actually like Ritsu, but when Death Prophet is getting trashed, I can't help but enjoy myself. I really don't like her, in case you haven't noticed.
Yeah, you've said that like 8 times or something.
I'm sorry, I can't help it, dude.
No, it's okay, man. I heard this Yules on Lina's for, maybe to protect him against Slark, I guess.
Lina?
Yeah, she doesn't really have that many items, surprisingly. I was like, is this a support? And then I was like, no, she was farming. I guess she doesn't have that many kills. Shadowblade, Yules.
She actually got contested pretty well by Enchantress up in the top lane, and she only got a couple kills while roaming around. I mean, it's really been Limp that's been the most involved. I thought they should have pushed high ground with the Aegis, but what do I know? And that's not going to respawn for another 5.5 minutes. It's, I think, a long Roche respawn duration. Not sure.
Operation smoke time.
If this fails, is it just GG?
It's pretty close to that, yeah.
Well, there's only 2 heroes here, so this actually probably should go well. Swindle's just blinks away, though, so maybe not. Wave of Terror's gonna fly. They're not in anywhere close range to swap. They, I think, might have seen Chessy. They're gonna try to turn on this. He popped the Necro 3. They have Relocate. If they get another Blink and Roar, they can find a kill easily, and they won't go for it, though. They're too far away at this point, and so Complexity will back away together. They avoid the smoke gank. And that means that Shazam are corralled back into the base once they came.
Well, that's one smoke.
How many do they have left? Let's check.
Zero in store.
Have anybody on? Not on that the courier. It. That's their last smoke, huh?
Looks like it.
Mason just used his ultimate for nothing, really. So that's down for 54.
That's just a minute. It's not terrible.
Do they have a gem? No, I don't think so. They could afford one, though. They can get one.
And the Wisp is still farmed. He's got like almost every single regen item.
Yeah, he really does. Urn, bottle, mech's coming soon. There's the gem I was talking about, by the way, which I guess you can get away with just having the Necro 3, but I really like the idea of having a gem, especially on the off. I mean, Beastmaster already got a solo kill on Mason, and he's in the jungle, so unless they smoke again as 5, which they don't have for a couple of minutes, this is going to be just fine for him. He's going to be able to control the jungle, get a couple supports over here, get some wards down. And this leaves pretty much only top lane to be farmed in mid lane, really just the lanes when they're pushed in general. What does Ritsu have? He's got a drum, he's picked up an Overcooked Club for probably BKB.
He's got to get as much cheap HP as he can, basically, because at this stage he's not going to get any of those big items like Green Core. He just needs to try to survive the burst and siphon soul up some HP and get the damage.
That's a 24 minute AC. Plus blink ags. What's his GPM looking like? I'm sure it's not that high. 587, that's pretty good. Got up only the 8 ages too. Then in this game, it's not going to respond until I think 3 minutes from now. So they'll probably just play back and farm, maybe find a pick or two. I like how Shazam is moving with each other though.
The board does 60 damage at level 4. It's pretty good. So good for pushing. It's not very good for heroes because piercing gets halved, I think, against heroes, but creeps, it's really strong.
I actually don't know the different dynamics between piercing. I guess they didn't change all that. They made damage types a little bit easier with physical and composite and all that stuff, but I forgot about piercing and siege damage kind of completely. Was
some of the most hidden aspect about damage in Dota 2. Like, why does a Venomance ward do 38 damage but do like no damage to a hero? That's why.
Yeah, that makes sense. Swap out.
Oh, they found
Magic Missile, but he actually gets wheels up. Here's the relocate. This is not going to be a good fight. Good snowball. They actually silence on to 3. The Nightmare comes out of Jesse. He's in trouble. Can they kill Ritsu? That Siphon is just not doing enough. They've lost 2 already.
Still Twiddle alive.
Gets a double kill. Mason actually getting out. Dark Pact with the right foot comes in. And the Limp Cleave comes through and gets that pickup. Brax does get a double kill. One of those is Chessie. They're still on pursuit as SVG is going to get caught here in a second. Toss 4 could do the job here. Yep, there it is. Avalanche will connect as well. Z-Freak has got the Brain Temple. He'll use it. He'll get a Dominating Spree. 4 dead. They do have buybacks on both of their cores. That did go down besides, of course, well, both of the cores. But
it's a really nice try by Shazam to put a sentry there and wait for the Invis hero because they saw the Shadow Blades. So if they just found a hero, man, they could get a kill, and they did find a hero.
GG is called, Ritsu just goes out of the game and says, that's it, I'm done so. That's a little BM.
That's some drama right there.
Yeah, see, that's what I was looking for.
Now that I've got it, leave the game before your team is ready to GG.
I mean, maybe he actually DC'd. Yeah, right, what's the chances of that? Yeah, Lip is gonna get caught. We actually lived. Alright, good first game for Complexity. No nervous issues, no real problems whatsoever, and they get the game. They'll get a very easy victory at 26 minutes, and it's looking strong for them, looking solid, Purge. Gotta say, it looked really nice.
It's fun to see the heroes that we, like, 2 games ago thought were OP, see the cracks in them. Enchantress can't deal with 4 heroes that have a strong nuke. Prophet has trouble against strong dual lanes, so.